Hi everyone. So in this video, I'll be showing you how you can create your own Q&A ChatGPT with your own Excel or CSV data. So I'll be doing this with the help of Langchain and OpenAI API. So let's get started. So the prerequisite for this video is going to be you must have Python installed in your system and you must also have a CSV file. So first thing is just open a folder in your editor. I have Visual Studio Code over here. I am inside this folder. After this, we just need to import our CSV data. So I'm having this data file. I will just drag and drop this inside my folder. And this is the data that I am having. So once you are good with the CSV data, we need to install some Python packages, which is going to be Langchain and Langchain Experimental. So just open your command prompt. And if you just Google Langchain Experimental, we'll be getting this. Just copy this and go to your command prompt, paste it, and install this one. So once this is done, you can just reuse the exact same code and now install only Langchain. That's it. Now we are good. So these are the two necessary things we need to install. And now let's just begin to code. So just click on this new file and let me name my file as main.py. So first thing is we need to import OpenAI from Langchain. So it's going to be from Langchain import. It's going to be OpenAI. So make sure that you are following this lowercase and uppercase things. And next is going to be from Langchain Experimental. So it's going to be from Langchain Experimental dot agents dot agent toolkits space import. We'll be importing the create CSV agent. So it's going to be create CSV agent. All right. So this is the full thing. And next thing is we need to like mention our file path. So in case you are having your file in some other folder, I would recommend you to have this inside the same folder so that you can just, you know, give the name alone and type less. So I'll just have it as file path. And since I'm within the same folder, I will be just directly giving my file name. In case if you are having like within some other folder, you need to give the whole path over here. I'll just give my file path with the extension. That's it. And next is going to be the OpenAI thing. So we need to create our LLM. So it's going to be LLM, which is equal to OpenAI. And here we will be passing a few parameters. So the first parameter is going to be temperature. So this basically is used to determine the randomness in the output. So if we give temperature equal to zero, which means that we'll be getting highly accurate output. And next parameter is going to be the OpenAI API key. So it's going to be OpenAI underscore API underscore key. So you need to specify this within single quotes. And I'm just going to directly hard code the API key over here. In case if you're, you know, going to like push this code for production and something, I would recommend you to have this in an environment variable file, something like that. So you need to follow the same naming convention like this. So for getting the OpenAI key, same thing, you need to go to OpenAI official website. And I hope you have an account in ChatGPT or OpenAI. Just select this login and you need to go to API. And to the left, you'll be having API keys. And here you'll be having your create new secret key. Just click on create key and okay, they have a puzzle now. So once you solve that puzzle, you will be getting your key. Make sure that you copy this and never share this key to anyone. Just click on done. After copying, just go to the code. I'll just paste the key inside single quote. That's it. Now we are good with the OpenAI key. And next thing is we need to like initialize our agent. So it's going to be agent equal to create CSV agent, the other thing that we had imported. And within this, we need to pass our language model, which is OpenAI in this case, comma. Next thing is going to be the file path. And we'll also be having another parameter as verbose equal to true. No, I just did this as a default parameter, just copied it from their code. So this is fine. And final thing is, let me just show you how you can run a prompt in this. So it's going to be agent dot run and let me just ask a question to it. Let me ask it, how many students past. All right, the reason why I'm asking this question is because I have a column named pass, so I'm just having a boolean value yes or no over here. So I'm just asking this question. I will save it, and for running it we just need to use Python space with your file name. So it's going to be Python space file name with the extension. So this is just a warning, it's fine. And here you can see this is the thought, this is how it thinks. So it gives us the entire workflow, how its thought process is going. First thing is I need to count the number of students who passed exactly. And here we are having an action input. This basically determines the column in which it needs to count, because I'm having a column named as pass. So this is related to my question. So it just finds the number of yes and no in that particular column. And so it says final answer is 4 by determining the number of yes in the column pass. So this is how the entire workflow goes. And I would say this is quite accurate, but it's not like 100% correct always. So you must always cross verify after you are prompting. Okay, it's not like 100% or super highly accurate. That's like a disclaimer. And in case if you want to like automate this entire process, what you can do is you can just have a while loop, make it infinitely true. So something like this, while true, can have a colon, and we just need to get the input. So it's going to be prompt. Rather than running the program multiple times and changing the prompt, you can just do this, enter prompt, and here just a tab space because indentation is important in Python, and run, it's going to be prompt. That's it. So save it and clear this and rerun it again. So now we will be entering the prompt over here. So I'll just ask some of the total marks. So it says 340 over here. So 200, 250, 340. 340 is the right answer, and it has also given us the formula how this does the thing. So, and you can also type another prompt over here and continue the process. The entire code that I've typed is in the link in the description in my website. If you want to just copy paste it, you can just go to my website and just copy paste it. Check the description also. So this is basically how you create your own ChatGPT like Q&A with your own CSV data. And I hope you would have found this video useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. I've done a lot of videos in OpenAI, API, DALI, image generation API, as well as Langchain and other AI related videos and CRUD operation related programming videos. Check the playlist, subscribe me. Thanks for watching.